Okay, let's talk about adding rational expressions with like denominators. All right, so here we're adding two fractions together. Now, what's the most important thing to remember when you're adding or subtracting two fractions? That's right, you need a common denominator, right? That's what we mean by like denominators, simply that the denominators are the same. So here I'm just adding two fractions together, like we know how to do, and as long as the denominators are the same, what you do is you add the numerators, right? So 3 added to 8, this is going to be 3 plus 8 divided by the common denominator of 5, and that's equal to 11 over 5. So this is how you add fractions. Now, rational expressions are basically like fractions, right? The only difference is that you're allowed to have polynomials either in the numerator or the denominator or both. But the same rules apply. You still want the denominators to be the same whenever you're adding or subtracting. So in this case, the denominators are the same. I have like denominators. So what do you do? Well, you do basically what you did in the previous example. You simply take the first numerator, and in this case, we subtract the second numerator. So it's going to be x minus 1 minus 3 over the common denominator, which is 4x squared. And so then you combine like terms in the numerator. So x minus 4 divided by 4x squared. Now at this stage, you ask yourself, can you simplify? And the answer is no. And the reason is because you might want to try to cancel these 4s, but you never cancel whenever it's addition or subtraction. This 4 I could cancel because it's multiplication, right? But that 4 I cannot cancel because it's subtraction. So this would be my answer. So we have a polynomial over a polynomial. Okay, let's take another one like that. Let's add together these two rational expressions. Now remember, rational expressions are like fractions, and the most important thing to remember about adding or subtracting fractions is that they have a common denominator, okay? Like denominators. They do, so we simply add the numerators together. So it's going to be 7x plus 12 added to the numerator 5x plus 36. And then all over the common denominator, which is x plus 4. Now we add the polynomials, or we add the like terms. So we have 7x plus 5x, which is 12x, plus, let's see, 12 plus 36 is 48, divided by x plus 4. Now remember, we like to simplify if we can, and I can't cancel at this stage, but notice how I can factor that numerator as 12 times x plus 4. And the denominator can be, well, the denominator is just x plus 4. And you can think of it as x plus 4 times 1. So the x plus 4 and the x plus 4 cancel, and you're left with 12 over 1, which is just equal to 12. So the final step is always simplifying if you can, and that's why you have to take the extra step of factoring either the numerator or the denominator or both, and then canceling. Okay, let's try another one like that. Okay, here we're asked to subtract. So the same logic applies. You have to make sure the denominators are the same. They are. So what you do is you take this numerator, that is 7x plus 10, and you subtract the second numerator. Now, do you see how the second numerator is a sum right here because of addition right there? You want to subtract off the whole thing. And the way you subtract off a sum or a difference is by using parentheses. So we're subtracting off all of the 3x plus 18. That's one thing that makes this problem a little tricky. That's all divided by 5x minus 10. Okay, and then let's see, it's going to be 7x plus 10. And then you subtract off 3x plus 18, and that's the same as acting like there's a negative 1 right here and distributing it. So it's going to be negative 1 times 3x, which is negative 3x, and we write that as minus 3x. Negative 1 times positive 18 is negative 18, but we write that as minus 18. Okay, and then all over the 5x minus 10. So now combining like terms in the numerator, it's going to be 4x, right? 7x take away 3x. And now 10 minus 18 is negative 8. We write that as minus 8 over 5x minus 10. Okay, now remember, simplify if you can. And we can factor, right? Because it's 4 times x minus 2 divided by 5 times x minus 2. And now the x minus 2s, of course, cancel, and we're left with just 4 fifths. Okay, so that's how we add and subtract rational expressions with like denominators. Now, you may be asking yourself, what happens if the denominators are not originally the same, right? And the answer is, well, just like with fractions, you have to find a common denominator. And you do that by finding the LCD, okay? And we'll talk about how to find the LCD of rational expressions in the next video. Take care.